No, like, at some point we have to go onto the stage. No, you can't. You can't just start a show.
Alguai, one foot on the ramp doesn't count as the stage.
This is fine.
No.
There is. This is an incline. You son of this. You're gonna make all the way. Hi, welcome to AfriCon tonight. Nothing is happening backstage. There's just a small pyre I have to take care of.
That's the same thing as a fire. That word is not okay.
Sorry, just talk.
How's everyone doing? You know, it sounds like y'all and Alguai have a lot in common and that you're having too much fun at AnthroCon. And I have been told there are some common hallucinations you can experience from having too much fun at AnthroCon, such as... Trexler, Winter, Shadow, Randy, Cyan, Details, Pastel, Oasis, Indie, Honey, Wallcat, Rascala, Hugs, Scales, Snickers, Great Fox, Felix, Yuki, Toxic, Kentucky Duck, Jacuzzi, Vexum, Beaten. We're gonna have all of these acts for you tonight. I hope we're all excited. Up first is...
Up first is the one, the only, the definitely a cheetah, Trexler! Cheetah?
No.
But you're going to be singing Shivers, so it makes me shiver. Cheetah?
No.
Cheetah? Cheetah? Cheetah. I kept the microphone. Cheetah?
That's all right, I have this one.
Cheetah.
Say, ooh, I love it when you do it like that. And when you're close.
Give it up for Trexler playing Shivers! Up next, we have Winter Warburton playing Believe.
Screw this humidity. Thank you very much.
Ash Winter, up next to the stage. Let's hear it for somebody who was labeled as stand-up, parentheses, maybe. Let's hear it for Shadow!
Hello, Abracan!
Hello!
Oh, so it's like being here after so many years, isn't it? Honestly, this is actually the first time I've ever been to Evercon, the second for a convention I've ever been to, and I hope I keep coming back here again. In case you know, I'm here from Michigan. You can't really miss it. Yes, exactly. You can't really miss it. It's the one state that looks like this. As if they're saying, hi! We're still here, even if you don't care. That, amen to that. And getting here is not really so much fun. And I have been driving over here for about 5 hours, especially with a sleep, not a fan. It's just like one of those days, you're just driving, and all of a sudden you start drowsing up, then you wake up and realize, how the hell did I get here to Hawaii? I do love the furry fandom. I'm not a fursuiter, but I do respect the craft. But the reason I am a furry is because of the characters that we grew up with over so many years. And for me, it's really more of the personality that emanates from them. It's like the more relatable and likable kind. Me personally, I've always been a fan of cartoons like the Looney Tunes. Suck it, Disney. You may have been the happiest place on earth, but you ain't getting any more of my money. Okay, I have it. And the reason I say that of Looney Tunes is because they are the characters that are more relatable and more personality, because I feel that my personality is a little bit more like theirs, because there will become a time in which times, well, you know. I'll have a blue Christmas without you. Thank you for a key pick. And then other days, I'd be chucking being like, Pepe Le Pew, because we all want to be that very romantic kind of person. It's like, it is wonderful after all these years, is it not? But if I do it in real life, it just comes across as creepy or harassing. Other days, you kind of get like that kind of a character that be just like, just doesn't know when to shut up. It just talks on and on and on. You know, like Foghorn Leghorn. You know, like, I say, what's the matter with you, boy? Don't just stand there. Speak up. Say something. Say something. Your gums been flapping, but no words are coming out of your mouth. Boy, about as silent as a man. But for me, I think the one character that sticks to me the most is, believe it or not, Wile E. Coyote, super genius. And the reason I say that is because I like to be a very smart person, try to be intellect, try to be ahead of the crowd. But no matter what I do, no matter what I plan in the head, or whatever seems to come into mind, I can never win. Don't you just hate it? Only have those days you just can't win. Yeah, exactly. I also have to say, being here is just absolutely a fun time, and I hope it keeps going as such. And some of you may know, but I might be, if not the only guy that has the walk-up-full cooler full of ice bottles of water. And I'm always more than happy to offer it to anyone who's ever thirsty or just needs a quick drink. You guys are okay with that, right? Yeah. And the quote from one of my favorite movies, as you wish. Yeah. But that being said, I just want to thank you guys for taking the time and not throwing stuff at me. And that being said, thank you and
goodbye!
Thank you. Stand up. Yes! Give it up for Shadow! Please welcome to the stage Randy Ringtail performing You Gotta Be.
Thank you very much. I'm performing this song today because it's a very uplifting song, and with the way the world is right now, I feel everybody needs to hear it. So without further ado, You Gotta Be. Challenge what the future holds. Try and keep your head up to the sky. Lovers, they may cause you tears. Go ahead, release your fears. Stand up and be counted. Don't be ashamed to cry. Gotta be, you gotta be bad. You gotta be bold. You gotta be wiser. Gotta be hard. You gotta be tough. Gotta be stronger. We gotta be cool, we gotta be cool, let's get together. All I know, love will save the day. Tell what your mother said, read the books your father read. Try and solve the puzzles in your own sweet time. Some may have more cash than you, others take a different view.
So just so you know, the entire crew backstage is standing there as they're singing, because we can see the reverse on the screen. I watched my entire staff just in unison, which makes me believe I should bring them up here next. But instead, how about a dance routine? You guys want a dance routine? Yeah. Introducing to the stage, let's hear it for Cyan Glacier 2!
In this heat. Thank you so much. Turn around and safely go that way. Please do not fall into the darkness and void. We have that. And up next, we have for you, stand up more, yes, we have Details Dragnawolf. Come on up and give it up for Details.
Hello, Anthrocon. I made it look a little different than the last time I came on stage here. I finally made my first fursuit. Yeah, like, this was a lot of work. It only took, like, 6 months of my life, a job, and my dignity, but got it done. Yeah, so, luckily enough, I didn't lose my job, by the way, from making a fursuit. I lost my job because I can't stop playing Pokemon Go. Nah, like, my boyfriend loves it because it's like I've turned into the Christian evangelist of Pokemon Go. Like, I can't have a normal conversation. Oh, why are you at the mall? Oh, I'm playing mobile games. What games are you? Do you want to hear about my Lord and Savior, Pika Christ? No, I'm talking to 90-year-old ladies about the intricacies of raids. And I'm flexing on 5-year-olds who don't know what the hell I'm talking about. Yes, it was New York. Last year, I caught the shiny Charizard with the RNG that I have no control over. And I was eating a cheese danish at the time. Truly a pro. My boyfriend said it. The beginning of the year, I got into this weird poly relationship with a bunch of furs. So now, I live with 4 furs, and it's like a con every day. And by that I mean, everything is going wrong and money keeps going missing from my wallet. it's great. We set a few ground rules. Apparently the first ground rule that was set, because I'm a comedian, if you can make me cringe, you get points. My friend's not too bright sometimes. I had been making veggie broth all day, and they asked me to make coffee. And they run the night shift at their job, so I was like, yeah, I'll put some coffee in the fridge for you. I woke up to half a cupboard of vegetable broth missing. And they just came up like, wow, that coffee didn't help at all. Like, it tasted weird. It was like mushrooms. And I'm like, oh, jeez. One of my other boyfriends is a kobold, and that is awesome yet horrifying, because they can bench press me, and their favorite thing to do right now is just tackle hugs and squeeze me until I pop. So yeah, they put up with a lot of my bullshit, honestly. Oh well, okay, that's my one. Oh man. I will say this. They helped me on this fursuit head. I'm really glad about it. And I think my set I just scooted through my set so fast. Anyway, I've been Details Dragon Wolf. I have to go catch a Mewtwo.
Well done, well done. Yeah. Love you too, Mom.
Which one is the not
death? Please don't die on the stairs. Oh, God. No lawsuit. All right, next to the stage, it's your friendly neighborhood Pastel Nightmare.
This song comes with a prop. Everybody needs some sausage in their life, right? Pick the right crowd for this. Sing along when you get to the right spots.
1 minute I'm in Central Park, and then I'm down on Delancey Street.
Why should I and then they love me at the Ritz. Oh!
Why should I worry? Why should I care? Even if I cross that line, when I got street savoir-faire.
Thank y'all. Good night.
Thank you so much, Pastel Nightmare. I assure you, you have rocked the worry out of me. How about y'all? Well, now that the worry's rocked out of me, I think it's time for some chill, good music. Please introduce Zeke performing And So It Goes. Oh, and I forgot. And also, please welcome Cosmic performing alongside. Indie Timber performing a couple of instrumentals, and this should be really fun. This is one of the niftier ones I got to see as part of the auditions. Indie Timber, come on up. Thank you.
2020.
Let's hear it for Indie Timber! All right, our next person coming to the stage singing a song with a great name because of my stand-up. Wait a minute, wait a minute, wait a minute, wait a minute. Singing Wait a Minute, give it up for Honey!
Performing a lovely song from a group I adore, Desperado. And there will be some.
I'm the roadie.
Been out riding fences so long now.
you're a hard one. I know that you got your reasons. These things that are pleasing you, but you somehow. Don't you think?
Down, but you've got the power now.
we have even more, yes, more stand-up. We have Hugs with a Z. Please come on out. Give it up for Hugs with a Z. I love you too, Hugs.
I love you too, random citizen.
How's everybody doing?
Oh, good. There are at least a few more wolves in here. Now, when I was backstage, I had to talk a little bit with Alkali. You know, he's wearing a top hat, and I'm like, if you know anything about him, it's like, that's a first hat at best. So, but that aside, he was asking a couple of questions, like, are you going to be nervous up there, you know, performing comedy or whatever? And I'm like, yesterday I was wearing nothing but a Himbo Hooters outfit with the booty shorts and the crop top. This should be a cakewalk. So I apologize to everyone. I'm wearing more clothes today. It's like a very slow strip in reverse. But how's everybody doing at AnthroCon so far? Sensational. And a special thanks to all of you, because this is actually my first time, so thank you for being gentle. But, you know, the big thing here, obviously, the one thing this very diverse group has in common is that we all like something about anthropomorphic animals. So just to start something off very general, very basic, you have sort of something like Kermit the Frog will even work. You know, like, technically that qualifies. You can just imagine him and his conversations if he were here at AnthroCon is,
oh, hi-ho, Kermit the Frog here, and in case anybody really wants to know, Miss Piggy does, in fact, taste like a ham sandwich. Kermit, make more, keep going.
I'll pay for the therapy, it's fine. But there's just so much more. Like, we're all Disney addicts here, right? I mean, like, that sort of thing just was part and parcel of who we are and why we're here. Like, Stitch technically qualifies, right? An alien pretending to be a dog, like, look. A lot, half the people here are just organisms pretending to be a dog, so we should be, that qualifies. Imagine sort of, this is my family. I found it, all on my own. It's litter and broken, but still good. It kind of sounds like me or my psyche on a good day. But, yeah. And if this other thing just keeps on going, imagine sort of a Davy Jones, not quite as soft and fluffy as a lot of us might like, but imagine something along the lines of sort of, do you feel death? Do you feel that dark abyss? It sounds like I'm getting grilled down at the station again, which I'm not allowed to talk about until the case is settled, so don't ask. But, and we just keep on rolling through that sort of thing. I don't know whether, speaking of, you know, Pirates of the Caribbean, you know, they're playing things like Liar's Dice. I was playing that with a couple of friends a while ago. And one of my buddies, Dan, I sort of just snuck up behind him, and he was trying to roll a specific number, and he's like, hey, Dan, I thought of something funnier than 24. 25. La, 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 la. Holy shit, dude, I did not expect that sound to come out of your face. Does one just count as animals, technically? Yeah. But I would be sort of remiss if I didn't bring up one of my favorite himbos from the entire Disney franchise. I mean, we've all seen The Emperor's New Groove, right? Like, some people say that was after the Disney Renaissance. Like, no. The Disney Renaissance died with that film. Like that was the good stuff, and then everything after that was a train wreck for a while. But imagine, you know, I love Kronk so much, like the ultimate himbo. I sort of model myself after him a little bit. You can imagine something along the lines of just like, I got to meet Telephone yesterday, which was phenomenal. Like, if anybody here gets a chance, she's an absolute sweetheart. She does a pretty good flex herself. But Kronk speaks squirrel, which translates very loosely to a lot of Telephone squeaks. So there was a bit of a dialogue overlap there, sort of, I hate being in the middle. Squaker, squick, squickin', squick, squickity. He doesn't really want to talk to you right now. Now it's like, it's always, Kronk is just not complete without like Yzma sort of backing him up, just sort of just like, oh, how should I do it? Oh, I know. I'll turn him into a flea. A harmless flea. And then I'll put that flea in a box, and I'll put that box in another box, and then I'll mail that box to myself, and when it arrives, I'll smash it with a hammer! But, yeah, so that's my life. All these voices inside my head, don't worry, they'll only stay there. It might be nice to wrap up with perhaps one more little thing. Like, anybody see anything from Bibsy Pop, like Has-Been Hotel or Big Furry, so anything that she does technically qualifies, you know. Let's all wrap up with a little bit of like the best character from Has-Been Hotel. Like, I'm sorry, Alistair.
Yes!
You have no choice there, just sort of. Alistair, pleasure to be meeting you, sweetheart. Quite a pleasure. Excuse my sudden visit, but I saw your fiasco on the picture show, and I just couldn't resist. What a performance! But I haven't been that entertained since the stock market crash of 1929. Oh, so many orphans. Which explains why a lot of our grandparents didn't have dads and why eventually we kind of got here where we are. So, enjoy the rest of AnthroCon, everyone. Have a good one.
Say yeah, all con yeah. So yeah, all con. Well, that's not my name. You're missing a few syllables, buddy. Up next to this, I screwed it all up. I lost my order. You messed with me, man. Well played. Coming. Oh, I know why I screwed it up, because I don't want to call them by their real name. So up next to the stage is Scales and Snickers, but I found out they're both skunks. So I don't know. Give it up for Stink Floyd.
We're standing outside the house where this all started. Love was not enough, but I know we'll see it through. You don't have to believe me. You don't have to say you will. These days are far and few between, and I don't wanna miss them. Oh.
everybody. Up next, we have a fantastically dressed, a greatly dressed Great Fox performing Automatic Fox.
Well, hello there. I woke up this morning in a mind all alone. I got to myself, No, I never love myself unless I am somebody else. There's no need to check your prescription. Exaggerate a little fiction. Embrace your favorite affliction and dance your way out of your prescription. There's nobody that can stop me, baby. I'm an automatic fox. Gonna see what only I've been able to see. No wonder the truth inside will set me free. I'm an automatic fox. You're gonna see what only I've been able to see. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I'm an automatic fox. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I'm an automatic fox. The tail is growing longer from right between my legs. I feel the burning hunger. It's no use to try and beg. Now the fur is turning colors. I just can't stop it now. Why go against your nature? Don't wanna stop it anyhow. There's no need to check your prescription. Exaggerate a little fiction. Embrace your favorite affliction and dance your way out of your prescription. There's nobody that can stop me, baby. I'm an automatic fox. Gonna see what only I've been able to see. Only the truth inside will set me free. I'm an automatic fox. You're gonna see what I've been hiding deep inside of me. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I'm an automatic fox. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I'm an automatic fox.
What a great...
We're just all backstage watching the band, like, ah, woo, ah, woo. Oh, God, we're furries. Ah, woo, ah. Coming up next to the stage, let's hear it. Oh, no, no, I'm not going to screw this up. I actually was about to introduce the wrong person coming up. They're like, no, you're not reading properly. Yep, I got it right this time. Give it up for Felix!
It's not simple to say that most days I don't recognize me, that these shoes and this apron, that place and its patrons have taken more than I gave them. It's not easy to know I'm not anything I used to be, although it's true, I was never attention's sweet center. I still remember that girl. She's imperfect, but she tries. She is good, but she lies. She is hard on herself. She is messy, but she's kind. She is lonely most of the time. She is all of this mixed up and baked in a beautiful pie. She is gone, but she used to be.
Them, but they'll be able to hear you back there. During tryouts, it came out that that voice was told by their teacher that they shouldn't sing. And if right A few years later, they went to a competition where all the students from that teacher were there, and when they won, they thanked her for the award. So, they got their revenge. Let's give it up one more time for Felix. Up next to the stage with Impressions of Angel, let's give it up for Yuki!
To introduce Toxic Wheeze, who wants to dance for us. Toxic!
Open Gangnam Style!
Gangnam Style! No. This ain't my song. It's time to redeem myself.
Hey now, hey now, hear what I say now. We'll be
If you're alive, get off the stage.
Thank you for surviving.
AB, to be clear, that was Alkali's mic. Alkali, take your mic. Go face your shame. Toxic, this way. You're judging, I know. I can feel it from Mal the way back there. Front there. Next, we have even more wonderful stand-up. Please welcome to the stage, Kentucky Duck. Woo! Yeah! Oh, this is the first time I got to see the outfit in the light. It's so good.
That one right there. Yes.
Howdy. I am the Kentucky Duck, and that is two reasons why I have no teeth. I am genuinely from Kentucky, where the fried chicken comes from. So, yes, you're welcome, sir, or ma'am, or what have you in the wonderful drop-down menu of life we have these days. Honestly, I could be talking to an empty chair. I have no way of knowing. I know it's confusing because I've got those follow-me eyes, which are absolutely excellent at making every interaction passive-aggressive. I could be hugging a dude and I'd just be side-eyeing the whole room. Well, I wrote up 5 minutes of material, could have just done that. So I do genuinely come from a tiny, tiny town smack dab in the middle of Kentucky. Tiny, tiny town, so small, our zip code had a decimal place in it. The population sign said, weather permitting. You could shove somebody and run them out of town. If you lay down to go to sleep, your feet will pay taxes in a different municipality. One time I was arguing from somebody from my hometown about Kentucky's role in the Civil War, because that's what you do in a tiny town. And I argued that Kentucky never officially seceded from the Union, because I was right. And in response, this man legitimately, genuinely, reached for his belt buckle to open it up to reveal a history of the Confederacy. I didn't know I was arguing with a fellow academic. I don't know what the strunken white bibliographic standard notation is on a groin, but I feel like if you have to point to your pants in a debate, you are not winning in the marketplace of ideas. A tiny town. One time I had to go visit a town doctor in the back of the auto care center, and I genuinely wish that was a joke. They told me I had to wait to see the doctor because she was next door cutting someone's hair. I'd have been less upset, but that someone was a poodle. Grew up poor, not really poor, but we didn't eat out of the Cool Whip bowls and the Hillshire farm tubs, but a certain amount of our flatware was from the McDonald's merchandise collection. I could come home and see that we had out the Hercules plates. They'd be like, ooh, company. We also had those white plastic bowls, which had forever been stained with a thin layer of Chef Boyardee sauce, like some sort of curse from some sort of Feywild Tir na n'Og orange curse. We're doing a little bit better than that. We bought red bowls. You know, we were so poor growing up that we had a hot tub. I know some people over here don't seem to understand that, although, again, I could be looking straight down an aisle. If you grew up poor, if you were not that family, then your brother or your cousin or your uncle, which I recognize in Kentucky are not mutually exclusive categories, they had the hot tub and they had the jet ski and they had the boat. Because if you're already $30,000 worth of credit card debt, who cares? You might as well. Ain't no such thing as a credit score out on the lake. golly cheapers. I think this flashing light means that that's my time. So thank you very much for having me. Thank you very much. You have a great audience. You all guys have a great after time.
Let's hear it for Kentucky Doc! And haha, my microphone still works, Dragor. Let's hear it for the one, the only, the soulful Vexum! Thank you.
was introduced to me was, what is your act? I'm like, oh, I'm performing a jazz meme. Up next, we have a wonderful, wonderful performer. Please, I do hope you all enjoy this. Again, it's a little bit different in the best way possible. We have Beaton performing Nessun Dorma. The stage. Give it up for all of the Anthrocon Tonight support staff.
A huge thank you to Cosmic, Rhubarb, Icy Backstage, everyone who made this possible, and of course your director of programming, Ash, for making sure it happened.
And Alkali and Dragger for hosting this thing and wrangling people backstage. And look, we got a special guest who just showed up. Putting him to use.
Ooh, I like those things.
Yeah.
I'm useful.
All right. Go, go.
Sang a tune, would you stand up and walk out on me? Lend me your ears and I'll sing you a song, and I'll try not to sing out of key. Oh, I get by with a little help from my friends. I can't hide with a little help from my friends.
Video that's not a jibe. All of you go to his YouTube channel and like and subscribe.